make anything out of these people.
Thank you.
Check. Check. Give us all your names. No, I'm kidding. Tell us your name, your age, and what instrument you play.
Oh, I'm Robert Knott. I'm 20. And I play drums for Scum of the Earth.
Can you tell us the history of the band?
Well, me and Chris, Chris and I, and Robert Holt put the band together with another guitarist. He since is no longer with the band. And then we needed a vocalist if we wanted to do any shows. So we got Mo, and he came in.
Is he permanent or just temporary?
Well, he has this project that he's doing. It's kind of like psychedelic jazz, and is the Riddler. Yeah, and if he decides to stay with us, we're glad to help him. You know, if he wants to stay with us, but you know, I don't think that's really what he's gonna do.
Well, we saw the article in the Lake Highlands newspaper and wanted to know how that got set up.
That was a friend of ours, Johnny Edwards, who he went to Houston with us, and he decided to put a little something different into the newspaper instead of just social events and preppy gatherings and things like that.
Where did the band get the name from?
Chris thought it up, and it's basically a sarcastic, it's kind of like making people face what they do. You know, people, you know, think of us as like scum of the earth, and you know, they don't really look at us that great. Meanwhile, we're not doing so much bad stuff when everybody else in the world is doing real bad stuff. And we're the ones that get tagged scum of the earth when you got politicians and all those religious fanatics, everybody else.
What different kinds of influences can be found in this band?
You got jazz, jazz fusion, rock, blues, lots of things. It's like a bastard group, if you can say that.
What bands were you influenced by?
Everything, you know, jazz, you know, like the music we were influenced by is, the bands we were influenced by. We're heavily influenced by, you know, Iron Maiden, you know, just everything. We just kind of like suck it in and put it out as us. Yeah.
Future.
Well, if we can come up with the money, we'll do it, but we don't have any money.
What about the live demo that was in the featured in the article?
That's like one microphone in the middle of the room and you can't hear what's going on. Hopefully we're going to be making one tonight if, you know, if sound comes out right.
Next to the name of your band, there was a peace symbol. What was that significant? Be quiet. Okay. I cannot say this word, her. Okay, next to the name of their... God! I'm not... Okay, the peace symbol, what is this significant for?
Well, we believe in peace like everybody else should. You know, everybody says, oh, we believe in peace, we don't want any war and stuff, but, you know, there's people that want peace and just sit naive away waiting for peace. And then there's people who say they want peace just to look like a good guy. And we're sort of in between. We're willing to, you know, stand up for, you know, our idea.
What kind of peace? Considering all the skinhead action going on, you think it was peace between the races, but what kind of peace do you basically stand for?
First of all, peace within yourself. And then when you get peace with yourself, then it reflects onto the rest of the world, because most that happen where people are hurting each other or, you know, prejudice is more, you know, no self-respect, so you don't respect anybody else. And, you know, as far as skinheads go, you know, I don't want to get involved.
If we could get a shot of that over there. Exactly, what is this new cross banner for? What does this mean?
Okay, this is basically, what it means is it's religion signified by Christ on the cross. And the snake signifies evil, and the dove signifies good. And evil is taking more importance now. Things that are, you know, evil like greed, power, prejudice, you know, deviance, in whoever's eyes, you know. Deviance is one thing, and it's just basically, you know, good is overpowering bad at this moment in time. So that's what it means.
Didn't you mean bad
overpowering? Yeah. It, you know.
We know. What plans does the band have for the future?
Well, we're trying to get out on the road, so some record companies will notice us, Because if record companies see that you get your act together and go out on the road by yourself with your own money, basically, you're dedicated enough to go out on the road with money in your pocket from the record company. But it's fun. We get exposure. We get experience. And you know, we just get better every time we play.
Do you have any closing words for the viewing audience out there?
Well, just treat each other right and come to see us with an open mind, because that's what you need to listen to our music.
So don't worry, be happy. This was Laurel at this place, Planet Something. What is the name of this place?